ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओम शांति शांति शांति। वर्ष नंबर 230 सत ब्रह्म कार्यम सकलम सदेवम तन्मात्रमेतन्न तत्त्वान्यदस्ति अस्तीति यो वक्ति न तस्य मोहो विनिर्गतो निद्रितवत् प्रजल्प। I repeat one more time. Sadbrahma karyam sakalam sadevam anamatram etanna tato anyat asti asti iti yo vakti natasya moho vinirgato nidritvat jalpa. The translation is, so too the entire universe being the effect of the real Brahman can be nothing other than it. It is of essence of that and it cannot exist apart from that. Anyone who says it does, it is still under delusion and traders like one is deep sleep. See the one more time translation. Similarly, the whole universe being effect of the real Brahman is in reality nothing but Brahman. It is essence is that and it does not exist apart from it. He who says it is under delusion. He babbles like one asleep. The topic is going on. The seeker asked a question to the master. If Brahman is one without second, then what about the universe? Because it is a seeker. So his problem is the world. There are some principles, some philosophy, they accept that there are three realities. One is God, another is individual soul, and third one is the universe. It is easy to understand. We can understand it very easily because we are a spiritual seeker. So this theory can be understood very easily. There is God, good. Another, there is individual soul and everybody. And third one is the universe. These three things, these three divinity, it exists, then this question is not possible. But here, Vedas says the supreme reality is one without second. So being a seeker, it is clear principally he is accepted that Brahman is. And for who is not seeker, just a common man, for him the question would have been very opposite way. He would ask, is there self? Is there Brahman? Because in the world, in the universe, there is no doubt. For a common man, there is no doubt about the universe. The universe is so strong, you cannot doubt. Here is a chair, how can you doubt it? Here is a tree, stone, Himalaya, water, fire, and every object works according to their nature. So no question of doubting. The common man would ask, is there God? Is there Brahman? Is there self? But a seeker, they principally, he agreed that Atman is real. But problem arises when the master says the not only God is, but it is one. The supreme reality is one, there is no other. Then problems arise. Non-dualistic thinking will create problems. If you accept duality, then there will be no problems. A materialistic person, like a scientist, he would ask, and he would say, there is no God. No God. Only world is. He is very confident. He is very confident there is no God. Only matter exists. For a common man, he has doubt. Their God may not. For a seeker, he agreed. Yes, there is God. There is supreme reality, absolute Brahman. Only question is, what about the world? And this is a very big question in spirituality. Not a simple. And this topic, Shankaracharya is explaining in very big way. He is giving so many examples. In previous talk, we heard that he gave example about cake pot or a gold pot, jar made of gold. So God is only reality, name and form, just imagination. Here, now to take example, another liver. Level of the Brahman. Sat Brahma Karyam Sakalam Sadevam. Remember the example was clay pot. In that pot, in that jar, only clay is reality. Name and forms, it just imposed. Here, Sat Brahma Karyam Sakalam. This universe is like a pot. This universe is like a pot, like a jar, which made of Brahma. Sat Brahma Karyam. So this all universe is effect of the Brahman. Is it clear? This all universe is effect of the Brahma. Sakalam. And one more thing. Cause and effect, like you make a building and you are separate, your building is separate. You write a book, you are separate, your book is separate. You are not same. Building is different, you are the different. Your food is different, you are the different. Food is your work. The book is your work. The building is your work. Here, this method is not applied. Sakalam sadevam tanmatram evam. Listen carefully. Be attentive. So here, cause and effect is like gold and pot. Material cause. So you cannot separate the material cause from its effect. Tanamatra means tanamatra. Tanamatra means only that. In gold pot, there is only gold. In clay pot, there is only clay. Name and forms, just imagine it. So here in this label, only Brahman alone is reality. All other things, name and forms, are imagined. And they take so many changes. The substratum is the Brahman. And we impose sometime. At previous talk, I gave example like gold pot. You have a gold jar and you take it to jeweler and he melt it and give another form, another name. After some time, he can melt again it. He can give another name and form. But the stratum is the gold. All other things are projected. So whatever we are seeing, whatever we are watching, we are experiencing, this is the name and form. These always takes changes, always takes change. Somewhere very fast, somewhere very slow, but changes are going on. Now take an example. Like a grass. Like a grass. Grass, its color is green. Its taste is very different. Its smell is different. Size, name, all things are very different. Green grass. And we give it to cow. eats the grass, now takes another form. It takes another form as a milk. So now the same grass becomes milk. Before some time it was grass. Now it has become milk. Its taste different, smell, touch, color, everything very different. No one can imagine that. Before some time, this milk was in form of the grass. So milk is just rearrangement of the grass. Nothing else. And after some time, milk becomes yogurt, then so many modifications, then we eat and it becomes excreta and again grass. One thing is substratum. We should not forget that. One thing is there all changes takes place. That is why we call the universe is like a cycle. The universe is like a cycle. It is round. That is why in our scriptures are written yatha dhata purvam akalpayat. The Brahma creates new creation, but in the same way as they were before. Nothing new. Everything the same. So Shankaracharya says, tanamatram etanna tadanyasti. The whole universe, it is just the Brahman. You are seeing Brahman continuously, but you don't realize it is the Brahman. The problem is only you don't realize. You are watching Brahman, you are living Brahman, you are seeing Brahman, you are hearing Brahman, everything, you have no other option. The only problem is just a small problem, not a big. You don't understand. You don't realize you are living in Brahman. You are eating in Brahman. You are hearing in Brahman. You are watching in Brahman. In Gita, Lord Sri Krishna says so many times, Brahmarpanam, Brahmavi, Brahmatnav, Brahmanahutam, Brahmaivate Vedantavyam, Brahma Karam Samadhi. Just little problem. Everything is Brahman. The food is Brahman. You are also Brahman. Your hands are also Brahman. Your system in the body are Brahman. Brahma Arpanam, Brahma Havi. Everything is Brahma. Only just little problem. You don't realize it. Tan Matra. Anyad Nasti. There is nothing else apart from the Brahman. There is no other entity. If someone says, now Shankaracharya gives option, astiti no vakti. If someone says, no, there is the world, it is a trip. It is a trip. As it is. It is as it is. So he says, now, this person is under illusion. And he is giving example, Nidrit Prajalpa. Like a person who is in dream state, and he is shouting, "Save me, here is elephant, here is lion, they are after me, save me, save me." And you are by the person. So what you should do? What should you do? You cannot save the person to enter his dream. There is no way. You cannot enter, and you cannot even see the elephants, the lions, the forest. You cannot see. But he is real. He is seeing. So this is the very problem for you and for him. If you want to help him, you cannot give you instructions. You cannot protect him from the lion, from the elephants which are in his dream. How can you protect? You cannot enter. Even you cannot see. Because you both are very different states. He is in dreaming state and we are in waking state. You cannot protect him. You cannot save him. You cannot deny him because he is right. Absolutely right. Lion is there. Elephant's there. He is running. He is running for his life. And you cannot do anything. And the same problem is with the realized master and for us. Because we are in another level. Whatever we see, we heard, whatever he is saying, we will not be able to hear the same meaning. If you want to help that person who is in dream state, only way is get him wake up. There is no other way. If you want to help him, you cannot enter his sleep. You cannot enter his dream. You cannot fight for him. If you want to help him, just get him up. Throw some water, cold water, and he would be safe. The same condition is the realized person and ignorant person. We are crying, we are miserable, we are angry, and we always want someone to come and help us. And we are crying, "Help us, save us." And the great masters, the realized person wants, the realized persons always want to help us. But how? How? Is a very big problem for them also. And Kabir said, Kabir was a very great master, and his saying is very, very simple. He says, "Whatever I experience, I cannot say to you. If you want to see, you experience it. I cannot enter your dream world. So, as in dream world, for a dreamer, there is a lion, there is an elephant, they are running after him, they may kill him, but you are aware. You know, there is no elephants, there is no lions, there is no fear. Only fear is the dream. So just break his dream. Just give a shock and our dream will be finished. Shankaracharya says, Nidrit Bhak Prajalpa. Don't listen, don't take them serious. Now, another. Brahma eva idam vishvam ittevam vani srutahu srauti prute atharva nishta varishtaha tasma deta brahma matram hi vishvam nadhishthana avinnata aropitasya. One more time I chant it. Brahma eva idam vishvam ittevam vani srauti srute atharva nishta varishtaha तस्मादेतद् ब्रह्ममात्रम् हि विश्वम् नाधिष्ठानात् अभिन्नतारोपितस्य. See the translation. Really, this entire universe is Brahman. This is the declaration of the Atharva Veda. Therefore, this universe is Brahman alone. For a supreme position has no existence independent of its substrate. See the translation once more. This universe is verily Brahman. Such is the august pronouncement of the Atharva Veda. Therefore, this universe is nothing but Brahman. For that which is superimposed on something has no separate existence from its substrate. Now, there is a principle, a rule. Just remember, the rules is there is the supreme post has no separate existence from its substrate. I repeat the rule, the principle. The supreme post has no separate existence from its substrate. Still, Shankaracharya had given so many logics. He tried so many ways to convince, to make understand a seeker, a disciple. But in our this spirituality, anyone can ask, who are you? How can you say that? How can you say that? You believe, I believe that Shankaracharya is great incarnation of the God. But not everyone believes. So how can you say that you are right? You are correct. That is why he is giving now support of the Vedas. ब्रह्म एव इदं विश्वं इत्येवं वाणी श्रुति बुद्धिः. Shankaracharya says, this is not my logic. See, the greatness of the great masters. They always are so humble. So humble, so egoless. He was a great master. But he is not taking responsibility. He is not egoistic person. He says, "This is I'm not responsible for make this principle. I'm just a medium. I'm just a vehicle." This is the principle from the Vedas. So one thing remember, your logic should be verified from the scriptures. Scriptures are the authority for unknown matters. like spirit. We are not supreme authority. So Vedas says, that is why Shankaracharya is giving example from the Atharva Veda. Atharva Veda, there is an Upanishad, we call it Mundak. Ish Ken Kat Prashna Mundak. So Ish Ken Kat Prashna Mundak. Mundak is the fifth in sequence. Mundak is the fifth. And this is a part of the Atharva Veda. There are four Vedas, as we know. And Atharva Vedas, there is Mundak Upanishad. In Mundak, this Mundak Upanishad begins with a traditional method of succession of great knowledge. How it was started, how it was descending from one great master to another. And here is, in this Upanishad, very beginning, the supreme knowledge, absolute knowledge, knowledge of the Brahman, which was given to Brahmaji. And Brahmaji, who is the Brahmaji? Brahma is the creator of the universe, you know. Brahma is the creator of the universe, as common man knows. But in Upanishad, there is written, Brahma is the teacher of the universe. Teacher of the universe, not the creator. Brahma is the teacher of the universe. He was the basis of all knowledge. He had attained knowledge from the God. So Brahma got knowledge from the God, and now his responsibility is this knowledge should be transmitted to the world. So his eldest son was Atharva. Brahmaji gave this knowledge to Atharva, and Atharva this knowledge gave to Angira. Angira this knowledge gave to Bharadwaj. So this way, the knowledge of Brahman has been transmitted to the human society by Brahman Ji himself. So Brahman Ji is not just a creator, he is a teacher also. So Bharadwaj, then there is this head, there was a great householder. So this knowledge not only for sannyasin. This knowledge is only for sannyasin, not correct. So there was a great householder, his name was Saunak. So Saunak had reached to Bharadwaj and he asked so many questions. Then this Upanishad starts. So this is the Upanishad, Mundak. Here, there was a mantra. Vishwamevam vani srauti srute atharva nishtha varishtha. So Shankaracharya says, in this Upanishad, there is a very great statement made by the Sruti. This statement is, there is only Brahman. Brahma eva idam. Idam, whatever you are seeing, whatever you are experiencing, nothing else, just a Brahma. Nothing else. It is a Brahma. Tasmat detat Brahma matram hi vishwam. Now Shankaracharya begins again. Is saying, Tasma, therefore, because whatever I am saying, whatever I am explaining, the same thing is coming from the Vedas. Vedas are saying, I am just translating. The source are the Vedas. I am not the source. I am just explaining, transmitting. I am not the source. That is why in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Sri Krishna said, Tasma Sastram Pramanam. Lord Sri Krishna also, he is not taking responsibility. He is saying, the scriptures are the authority. Scriptures are the authority. You follow. I am also following. No one can, no one could be authority. The supreme authority is the scriptures. Shankaracharya says, Tasma, therefore, now Shankaracharya begins again the same principle saying, Tasma, Brahma Matram hi Vishwam. This all universe is nothing apart from the Brahman. This is just a Brahman. Just a Brahman. Nothing apart the Brahman. You see, experience. Only thing is your approach to the Brahman. If you communicate Brahman through the sense organs, through the mind, through the senses, then it will appear as a universe. If you connect yourself with anger, with greed, jealousy, misery, so then it would be objective. When you connect yourself with devotion, it would be God. Only the same thing, how you connect it, how to connect you, yourself. If you connect yourself with greed, lust, desire, anger, jealousy, it would be object, but it is a Brahman. Your way in approach is very, very lower class. So that is why it becomes object. But when you connect yourself with devotion, the same things becomes God. Godliness was previous also there, but we didn't have the eye to see the godliness. We had only vision for watching objectiveness. But when you developed the vision, then the same objective world becomes God. And godliness you can see. If you connect yourself through the knowledge, it becomes Brahman. Same thing. Nothing different. How to approach? Your approach will make much difference. Entity the same. Shankaracharya says, Tasma detat brahma matram hi visham. This universe, he is very emphasizing. Very emphasizing. Nothing different. See the confidence. Only realized person can say that. No other one have such a faith, such a confidence. Brahma matram hi vishwam. This universe is only Brahman. And one more principle he is giving here. Nadishthana bhinnata rupitasya. One more things we have to remember. This is the, in Vedanta, there are two words, Adhishthan and Aropit. I repeat, Adhishthan and Aropit. You have to understand it. Adhishthan means substratum. Aropit means imposed. Imposed. In Vedanta, these two words are very important. So we have to clearly understand these two words, Adhishthan, substratum, and Aropit, imposed. Take example. You are going in the forest. It is evening time. Darkness is getting. You are alone. And there is a post. A cut tree from the middle. And suddenly you see it may be ghost. You have watched so much movies. You never saw ghost. You don't have any idea about ghost. Because you don't have any experience about ghost. But you have collected so many informations from here, from there, from there. And suddenly you see there the ghost. And you impose the ghost. This is the ghost. Slowly, slowly, this ghost started developing. Slowly, slowly, you can start seeing these are feet of the ghosts. You can see his teeth also. Slowly, slowly, you started everything watching. The ghost's teeth, the ear, nose, feet, hand, everything. Whatever you have, think about the ghost. Slowly, slowly, you impose everything. You are imposing their teeth, you are imposing their feet, you are imposing their ear, eyes, nose, everything. And you become so afraid. Heartbeat becomes so fast. And suddenly, your friend comes. He says, no, why are you so afraid? He says, see, there is a ghost. Your friend says, no, I am going every time from this route. It's not ghost. It's just a pole. Just a porch. See, I can show you. And you becomes free from the fear. Post is still there. Same post is still there. Same half tree is still there. But ghost is not there. Before also ghost was not there. But you import it. You import it. So superimposition on the Brahman is the word. Ghost is there. And the ghost, the feet of the ghost, the eyes of the ghost, now nothing is there. Where have they gone? Where have they gone? They were not before. But you imposed. And that time you were so afraid. They may be cause for heart attack. See? The post is substratum. All imaginations are imposed. Same, Shankaracharya says, Adhisthana Abhinnata Aropitasya. Whatever you imposed is not different from the substratum. They are not different, they are not separate from the substratum. Only substratum is there. So the Brahman is substratum, the all universe is just superimposition. Now next one. Satyam yadi syat jagat etat atmano anantattvahani nigama pramadatah asattvaditumupeshutushya chaitanyam sadhu itam mahatmana naitatrayam. I repeat, satyam yadi syat jagat atmano anantattvahanir nigama apramadatah असत्ववादित्वम् अपीशितु स्यात् नैतत्रयम् साधु इतम् महात्मनम्. See the translation. If the universe as it is real, the Atman would not be infinite, the scriptures would not be false, the Lord himself would be guilty of having spoken an untruth. None of these three is considered either desirable or wholesome by the pure-minded ones. See the translation. If the universe as it is real, then the Brahman would not be infinite, the scriptures would not be would be false, the Lord himself would become guilty of an untruth. None of these three is considered either desirable or wholesome by the noble-minded. Now Shankaracharya gives an option. In case we accept that this world is real. As it is, it is a different entity from the Brahman. Its reality means what? Its reality means it has its own existence. It is different from the Brahman. So Brahman is one entity, the universe is another entity. These both are different entities. Then three problems will arise. One problem is the God would be not everywhere. Second would be the scriptures. And third would be with the great masters. Three problems. One is with the God, another is with the scriptures, and third one is with the masters. In spiritual practice, in the world of the divine, the world of the universe, reality, we have only three ways. Three supporters, three helpers, and these are scripture, God, and great masters. All philosophies, all spiritual practices, all religions are based on these three. For spiritual, though we must have faith somewhere, if a spiritual person, we have faith in these things. Because where you are going to try, you are going, your target, your goal is not visible. It is very unvisible. It is divine. So every religion all over the world have faith in these three. You have to faith in God. And what's the definition of the God? God is everywhere. Everywhere. It should be. God is everywhere. Because God is everywhere, God should be everywhere. If we accept that world has its own entity, it means the objective world is unlimited. Earth, water, sun, moon. And this world also occupies all its space. So God would be not everywhere. Like you have two books, two separate books. They have their own space. No other book can snatch the space of another book. If world is real, so world has its own space, and obviously God would be limited. So now God is doubtful. Then another thing is scripture. You must follow some scriptures. Without the scriptures, the religion, the philosophy is not possible. You must follow some scriptures, whoever, wherever you have faith. You have to follow holy books. So, scriptures. And third one is the great masters. Great masters. See, these three things should be very clear. Should be authority. If you have doubt in them, so God is doubtful, scriptures is doubtful, great masters is doubtful, the journey of the spirituality is not possible. You will not be able to move. Here, Shankaracharya says, because Vedas are saying, here is only one Brahman, and you are not ready to accept that, it means for you, scriptures are not authority. You are not agree with the scriptures. And you are also not agree with the God, because God is everywhere, you are rejecting. Third one, the great masters. So Shankaracharya is giving example. For a great master, only Lord Sri Krishna. See, in Bhagavad Gita, last one's mantra, Ishvaro vastu tatyagyo nachaham te savasthita nachamatistani bhutani itteva mevam dachi lirup. I repeat. Ishvaro vastu tatyagyo nachaham te savasthita nachamatistani bhutani itteva meva vachi klirup. The meaning is, the Lord who knows the secret of all things has expressly supported this view in his words, but I do not live in them, nor do beings exist in me. See the translation one more time. The Lord who knows the secret of all things has supported this view in the words, but I am not in them and the beings not in me. Now, the theory is about great master. Shankaracharya is giving example of Lord Sri Krishna. Lord Sri Krishna is the great master. He is God also, and here as a great master, who is giving direction to the Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita. There, Shankaracharya says, Ishvaro Vastu Tattvajna. The definition of the God is, who knows everything about everything. God knows everything. We are trying to know a drop of water. Still, there are so many things which are not revealed. They will be revealed. But God knows everywhere. In the earth, in the moon, sun, galaxies, unlimited objects, God knows. So God knows reality of the all things. The same God, the Lord Sri Krishna in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter 9, is saying that, what? He says, I am not in them and the beings not in me. So what is going here? A common seeker thinks, God is everywhere. God is everywhere. This is our concept. God is everywhere. In animals, in birds, trees, water, everywhere. Every particle of the universe, God is everywhere. He is residing everywhere. And another way is, of thinking, everything is in God, in Virat Roop. Lord Sri Krishna showed to Arjuna, see, everything is in me. So common man thinks, a seeker thinks, God is everywhere and everything is in God. And Lord Sri Krishna denies here. He says, no, I am not them and they are not in me. Because I am alone. I am without second. So you can project everything in me. You can project, see everything in me. You can see the moon in me. You can see the sun in me. You can see the water in me, sky in me. But they don't have their own existence. So this is the Lord Sri Krishna's statement. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purna Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Sankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Gavantau punapunah Ishwaro Gururatmiti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.